Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome aboard from EBS. I'm Suma Ubali and shall be your host for this webcast. How different is this morning? Indeed, very wonderful, right? The vibes around give us such an overwhelming feeling with such tech-savvy people to be attending this webcast. I hope you have been taking good care of yourself during this pandemic of coronavirus. And I feel honored to also welcome our speaker for today, Vikas Surani, Senior Pre-Sales Manager with over 10 years of consulting experience with Oracle, with whom you will be investing your next 60 minutes in an easy-to-understand yet intense session on EBS, the pace of change and transformation. We are wanting this session to be as interactive as possible, but with the time constraint, I request you all to type your questions in the questions tab you are able to see, which will be answered towards the end of the session. Without taking much of your time, I'll just cover the agenda that will be taken up today. So we will start with EBS roadmap. What are the options that are there if you choose to transform your systems? And then what is the approach that EOSIS follows for it? And then closing it with few successful case studies that we have done with. I'll ask you to sit back, Drew, and give your full attention as I hand over the session to Vikas Surani. Vikas, over to you.
Thank you, Suma. Good morning, everyone. Let's try to see what is the EBS release roadmap first. So as per the latest release in 2020 February, this is what has been updated over here. So in 2019, we have the latest release, which is 12.2.9. And Oracle has communicated that it is going to be continuous innovation model, which means that you are going to not get 12.3. It is going to be the continuous versioning from 12.2.x. If you see the scenario at this point of time, what has been updated from the Oracle is that the premier support will be provided for 12.1 up till December 2021, and for 12.2 for the subsequent release, and the 12.2 release would be till 2030. Now let's see whether staying with the e-business suite helps us to take or reach to the target or the expectation what our customers have it or what our employees have it. So if we see ability to respond where we are over here with the constraint of infrastructure, processes, and the resources, where the implementation might have been done, let's say, long years back, and the pace of change, which is quite exponentially growing. So change is now, and it's accelerating like anything at this point of time. So there is a new normal which is required as far as technology, product, and business models are considered. If you see certain third-party research reports like IDC, then they are stating that by 2022, majority of the organizations would be moving their applications on cloud, and it would be more of edge computing. Even if you see the report of OWM, it says that 14% of the respondent within the survey which they did was about lacking the cybersecurity as far as on-premises systems were concerned. So we feel time for changes now. When we say time for changes now, let's try to see what kind of options do we have. So option number one could be do nothing. So it could be a business as usual. We stay with whatever the version of Oracle e-business suites we have. It would help you to do the cost saving because you're not investing anything over and above. You are going to continue and keeping your lights on for the system. However, you won't be able to reap the benefits of the new module or the new features and functionalities which are coming up as per the need of the market. If you look one level beneath that, only the software cost is a small portion of overall total cost of ownership which you'll be having. It also involves the manpower which is required to admin and manage that system, security part controlling the firewall and the networking part, hardware and other items. If you look new functionalities which are, let's say, as far as cutting edge technology is concerned, like artificial intelligence, machine learning and other part, is not intensive or embedded part of the Oracle business suite system at this point of time when we speak. There could be a let's say, lack of scalability and robustness considering the model of on-premises it is. As we said about the support part, which is again, we know that this is going to end at this point of time. And the ERP upgrades, which you all know, are a major painful when the customizations are high. And normally the upgrades have been happening in average of 5 years. So these are the points where we feel do nothing should not be a good option, considering the deadlines which we have and the intrinsic value which it does not bring from the latest technology which is in the market. Second option could be while saving the cost, let's say we are having an on-premises install base at this point of time. instead of on-premises hardware, what we do is, rather than upgrading our hardware and the operating system and the infrastructure, we move our application either 12.1 or we do the upgrade into 12.2 and then move it into infrastructure as a service. It will for sure help you to save the cost. So the management of hardware and the facilities would be going to Oracle, as well as the updates which are required to be there, and the operating system management is also going to be with Oracle. So that will help you to reduce some cost of it. There are some potential benefits which have been depicted below, where you can reduce the overall cost of ownership considering keeping the same system. If you are looking for this kind of option, we have our customer cases where we have done such kind of engagement, and with the range of 6 months, 6 weeks to let's say 12 weeks of time, we are more than confident to at least move this infrastructure as a service for your e-business suite. But is this the right way of doing it? There could be a possibility of going into this option considering where you are within your, let's say, transformation journey. But we can discuss one-to-one if people are looking forward to this kind of options to migrate your systems into infrastructure. Third option, when we talk about the applications, it is about upgrading to the business suite. So if you see latest 12.2.9 and the version 12.2, they are having quite good enhancement. You talk about Enterprise Command Center, where you're able to do the composition of various modules which are incorporated into it. There are new functionalities like leasing and lease, which could be for certain customers where IFRS compliance is required, and it is embedded within that one. With regards to the approval flexibility, that are the announcements which are happening. If you see the cost of an upgrade, so these are the new features which you are going to get. But when we see the cost of upgrade, you have to invest additional dollars to upgrade. You will have an internal change management with regards to the new additions, and the learning curve would be there. Upgrading of hardware and operating system, if it is going, let's say, out of life, that could be the cost which would come in. And the ongoing cost of maintenance and the future upgrade is going to be retained if you go for the upgrade. We quickly try to check whether feature-wise and the holistic proposition to stay back in the EBS versus moving to the Oracle Cloud, is it good for us? So we have put up certain dimensions with regards to the solution, innovation, and the user interface. On the right-hand side, we have put up the values which is applicable directly with the e-business suite and what is available with Oracle Cloud. Talking few of the key components over here, one is the solution model. So Oracle Cloud is completely, let's say, SaaS-based solution. So you get most of the features out of the box from Oracle config Oracle system itself, so Oracle SaaS application. If there are any extensions which are required to be developed, or the integrations which are required to be connected with the third-party system, then you have a platform as a service which will help you to do so. Whereas in e-business suite, it will be retaining as is what you are currently doing, so which is a traditional on-premises model. You talk about the key item about the upgrades. So upgrade is something been taken care by Oracle when you move to Oracle Cloud. So you get a quarterly upgrades, which has been called as updates, which is, let's say, given from the Oracle. So you don't have to invest extra dollars as such intensive value which you are putting in e-business suite. Both of them are enterprise solutions, so need not to say that EBS is not an enterprise solution. We do understand, and we have been working in e-business suite for many years, and we do understand the value of it. But when we look about the innovation part, innovation is happening into the cloud. So you talk about the machine learning, IoT enablement programs and other part that you get it within the Oracle Cloud. So that are some of the benefits which you get out of it. Cost to value, so we feel the cost to business value. So you might not be able to, get more business value staying into the business suite, and there could be a better value proposition when you move to Oracle Cloud. If we talk about the numbers, let's say many of the CFOs or let's say the finance people who are currently within this webinar would like to understand what is the dimensions and how much I am able to save and how much able to get a better business value. So if you stay back in the on-premise system, 80% of your IT budget is just going to keep the lights on. It is about maintaining the system, maintaining the application, maintaining the infrastructure. This is what we are doing. To make some innovation, the 20% of the time in average is happening. Now, what if I can help you, or if we can help you with regards to moving this into different zone where the ratio changes high to do the innovation and the transformation, which gets 60%, and keeping the lights on, which is around 40 to let's say 20% of the time, which can happen with the Oracle Cloud. And we have live examples where this has been happened, and we are more than happy to share certain items with regards to this to help you create your business case with regards to the journey for your transformation. You talk about the Oracle Cloud component. So on the left-hand side, you can see the value Oracle Cloud brings in intrinsic time to value. So you the project is not taking the time which we used to take in e-business suit. It gets much faster. And with the accelerators which you have created for this journey is really helping many of our customers to move in a accelerated way rather than the delayed manner. When I talk about the new revenue models, so there are various good initiatives which are happening in Oracle SaaS, where the features are available on the go, and you can have an elasticity. If it is a requirement of, let's say, increasing a certain portion at certain time, that could be done without investing heavy in infrastructure for this item. On the right-hand side, you can see the models or the applications which are available from ERP, supply chain, HCM, CX, and the EPM components. In the center of it, you can see these have been embedded with the cutting edge technology. So I take a point of machine learning. So machine learning won't be required to be an extra cost for you. It would be embedded within the application where it will identify your patterns, and down the line, it will automatically suggest you these are the better ways of doing automation rather than doing the manual approvals and other kind of activities. The benefits which we have seen getting realized. So on the left hand side, we have tried to put what kind of numbers which we are looking forward about saving the cost, which is around 52% lower than what you are doing in on-premises. When you talk about the better information, so information is not in silos. You can have an embedded analytics and get the information within the application. So no need to depend on multiple systems to get the report of the requirement of the information which you want. To drive the business outcome, we have seen people, business getting more benefit with regards to the return on investment, what they're spending onto the technology investments. On the right hand side, you can see there is an IT support and cloud subscription. That is the cost which gets involved whenever you go for Oracle Cloud. But on the right hand side, you can see the various components which are not only about the software, but also managing that software and keep the lights on kind of concept. So that is becoming heavy as far as cost is considered. How business leaders are responding? So many of you would be also checking that how the world is behaving and what is that other people are doing. So the survey which has been done by Oracle, it says that staying on the current technology, which is like say staying intact with the cloud technology, 85% people wants to do that. So this is something everyone is wanting. Not everyone is starting their cloud journey at this point of time, but there is a roadmap into let's say the IT business blueprint to provide what is the right time to move to the cloud and what components can move to the cloud. This is what the respondent are responding to the survey. How we make it possible for you. So let's say currently you are onto the on-premises, which has been shown on the left-hand side, and we have created a program, which is EBS Glide. What we are trying to do is we have taken our 13 years of experience with regards to Oracle eBusiness Suite and on-premises application, and we have incorporated all the accelerators and all the phases of our learnings into one package, which is EBS Glide, to help you reach to the Oracle Cloud and to be the pace of change with the continuous improvement. Now, it is not necessary to move all the components in the Oracle Cloud. There could be a way where you would like to start testing the water, so you can adopt a new process and then move to Oracle Cloud for that particular process. Consider an advanced procurement, which you are not having into your on-premises application. You can have a coexistence model where you can connect your business suite with the advanced procurement of Oracle Cloud. You can move a business function. So let's say you are into an industry where you are in multiple businesses. So rather than doing a big bang change for the complete organization, you can start with one of your business function and that move that particular piece into Oracle Cloud to understand whether it is really viable for the wider audience. And many of the customers which you are seeing are taking this proportion when it is multiple line of business. You can go for the transformation of the business process. So a couple of customers where we have seen that they are feeling confident of moving into the cloud completely while transforming into the applications over here. So we have cases for all the three items. We are more than happy to discuss and provide you your tailor-made journey to the cloud, or let's say the option appraisal for you. When we see this one, the product is good, let's say the technology is good, but who is going to do that, or who is going to drive the transformation journey? So we believe there are some intrinsic ingredients which should be expected from the vendor. So we have just tried to put how we help you to bring more value on the table. As far as Oracle Cloud experience is concerned, we have now more than 1,000 Oracle Cloud customers, out of which 87 is the right number at this point of time. So we have 87 customers who has moved from on-premises system. When I say on-premises system at this point of time, it consists of Oracle eBusiness Suite, Oracle PeopleSoft, Oracle JD Edwards, and SAP ECC component. So these are the companies, or these are the products where we have moved them to Oracle Cloud. Out of which, just to bring some, let's say, numbers to you, around 20% of the customers are sitting in Middle East. So many of the customer cases are there within your region where we have done the transformation. We are a global organization, so we have presence around more than 20 countries, which helps you to leverage with regards to the ongoing support as well as the multi-country implementation. So that is something which could be helpful of. We have more than 1,200 consultants which are Oracle certified, and out of which we have around 200 consultants who are also having the background of Oracle eBusiness Suite. Now, there is a difference of telling that we are an Oracle cloud implementer and saying that we also have an experience of eBusiness Suite. So having knowledge of both the world is really helping our customers to understand left side of the things. And whenever we are putting on the right side of the things of, let's say, transforming to Oracle Cloud, they're able to understand the organization well, and the solution is getting better in this kind of scenario. On the right hand side, there are certain recent recognitions which you have received in Open World as well as Oracle Application User Group. These have been that. It is global. I mean, you can take Global Partner Year Award for the HCM. When you go to the ERP part, we have been specialized partner in the region of EMEA, and we have also won the Asian Partner of the Year. So we are getting this recognition globally. These are some of the customers where our presence is there. So we have a global presence of 30 countries, and these are the customers who are currently within your region. You consider the case of Salik, Abdul Latif Zamil Financials, Watani Insurance from the Financial Services. So across the verticals, we have certain experience. We are more than happy to discuss more about it and try to provide the vertical solution, which could benefit not only on the technology side, but also provide you more business values with regards to that. We'll try to have a quick check with regards to what kind of approach we have. So at least you understand that if at all I look forward for this option, what do I get? How do I start my journey? If you are at certain stage of your transformation currently, how do I get more value out of it? So we have kind of a combination of it, and we are more than happy to discuss in this subsequent slide and going forward post this webinar. Before I jump to that, just a quick check with regards to the C-level people who are sitting over here. Many of the people feel that having a right partner or having the right people would help us to get to the place where we want to. But when we see the strategic objective, that is more about becoming an efficient about your business process, you want to improve your service experience, and you want to have a new operating model to see better way of doing the business. Now, how could I achieve it? So it is not a one-party job. We feel it is a three-party job. It is a combination of people, process, and technology. To win the scenario and to achieve the strategic objective, this engagement model is required. When you talk about the people, it is about understanding and providing the executive support from the top level people to the transformation journey, which has been bringing more value to the organization. It also involves the change management. So we have seen many of the organization failing because of not having the right change management in place. We have the advices and the learning out of it, and we share this during the implementation journey to make sure that it goes in a right proportion to the end users as well as the business users who are going to use the system. Openness in hearing new thought. This is very much something is required when we go to the Oracle Cloud. There might be a different way of doing the things which you might be doing into Oracle eBusiness Suite, but you should be more adaptable of what the things are, and listen, openness to hear is one of the key criteria for it. When you talk about the processes, it is a combination of modern best practices, which is getting embedded within the Oracle Cloud applications. And as the EVO says, we are believing in a KPI-driven approach. So we just not look the system as an implementation. We look to provide, identify the right KPIs for you, which are the key performance indicator which you'd like to achieve from this. And then also provide you measures, how you can do the measurement and see the continuous innovation growth which is happening within your organization. Technology, of course, it is about the new system which might come into the organization, and try to see what are the process automation which I can bring within the transformation journey. This is the approach which we follow for EBS's client. So these are the five steps. So on the top side, you can see with the assessment and other item. Below it, if I do not have any accelerator or assets to help this phases, my project would go, let's say, for n number of years. But to make sure that we are able to get better value faster from the transformation part, we have created certain assets which helps us to pass through this journey in a better way. There could be a case where a customer does not start with step one, two, three, four, five, they can start directly with the implementation if the KPI or if the business plan is already ready and they know what they would like to get from the transformation part. We have seen quite few customers knowing what they want to get it from your from that digital transformation journey. And we have also seen certain people who are really starting to look for the option appraisal. So we have options for both kind of customers, and we are more than happy to do it. I'll be taking a use case of, let's say, how we did it for one of the customers, so that you will be able to understand in a better way rather than putting a theory of what we do in each phase. This is one of the customer which you wanted to highlight. This has been published in our website as well as in your Oracle. So this is London Borough of Lambeth in UK, where they have gone for the transformation of all the package. So which is ERP, EPM, HCM, and including the payroll, which is quite substantial in UK, moving the payroll to Oracle Cloud. The challenges which they were getting, this could be related to some of the challenges which you might be also facing currently. It is about the financial pressure. Just keeping the lights on is taking a lot of, let's say, dollars or values within the organization. That is required to be changed. Strategic decision making is something which was lacking for this customer. And the overhead, say, number of resources who are managing this is also one of the concerns. The benefits which they're getting over here is they are able to have a future fit finance team with the latest technology. And automation is one of the key items. One of the new interview which has been passed on by Lambeth, which specifically say the new generation of UK, or let's say the young generation, would like to go mobile. Now, to provide that mobile services, they have to be adaptable and they have to be with the current trend of the technology. And this is really helping and providing the platform to extend that applications for the customer experience. So this is how we see they're reaping the benefits out of the transformation journey. In nutshell, what we would like to do is we would like to get better. We would like to get faster, efficient, and the data driven rather than working in a silos mode. There are certain examples which you have given against each tab. Like say, when you talk about getting faster, it could be as simple as the monthly closure, which could be taking more than 10 days at this point of time, which we have seen getting reduced to 6 days. So it depicts that you are able to save the efforts as well as the cost overall, which is required to do that particular task. When I talk about P2P cycle, so there are better way of, let's say, touchless PO. This is something which we have embedded in many of our customers, and this is really helping them to get faster in the way they are doing. Efficient, I talked about the IT cost and the staff productivity, which is something I'll be speaking in subsequent slides. Paper usage is something really one of the key item which many of our customers are looking forward to. And we have seen it could be reduced as much as 80% considering the level of, let's say, usage what you're currently doing. And maintenance process, which is for the one of the program where you can automate the complete cycle of physical activities which your people are doing, and then connect back with the ERP system. Number of customers, so I talked about 87 customers where you transform. These are some of the logos which we have kept over here for your reference, and you can get more reference within our website also. Now let's try to see one of the customer journey which will help you to at least get a high level view how this process would work and what kind of benefits do I really get with each phase of the journey. So this is one of the customer which is in business of more than 60 years, and they are into natural gas contract compression service. Below you can see the strategic objective which they have levied out. So currently the number of compressions or the equipments which they are managing for the customers are around 3,700 at the time of 2016. Their 10-year vision is to increase almost double the total units. And what they would also like to do is the current ratio, which is let's say FST, which is field service technician, which is currently 5.1. So five machines are being served by one person at this point of time, or one field service technician. They would like to change this equation. So almost threefold the equation, where 13 equipments are being managed by one person. So you can see the strategic vision, how they are bringing. Now, if you stay with the current system, you might not be able to reach the way you want. But there could be a better way of automating the things. So this could be achievable. And we'll be talking about this item in the subsequent slide. Now, as many of you would be currently sitting on 12.1.3 instance, and this customer was no different. They were using 12.1.3. The database was 11G. And there were around 30 third-party systems which were getting connected and interacting with this Oracle Business Suite system. having a vision is good, but there will be always the problems with they're not able to reach to that vision. So let's say customer experience was one of the problem where they were not able to report back that how much time will it take to, let's say, complete the repairing process of the compression if it has been defected. They were also not having the visibility with regards to what is happening in different part of system. So that are some of the low visibility, and the information was in silos. You talk about adoption of latest technology. So they were not able to connect with the IoT, which is one of the key asks when they want to move from, let's say, 5:1 ratio to 13:1. Mobility. So this is more about going into the field and working in the field and then coming back for whatever the activities which are required to be in the office. So mobility is one of the key concerns with the facing with the e-business suite system. And for sure, not to forget, many of you would be also able to relate about the high IT cost which has been currently taken to maintain the system to keep it up and running. They knew moving to the cloud was there a way out, or that would be a possible way it could churn up. So they created a business case, and we also supported them with regards to the values and the business case which could be embedded within, let's say, the part of package. They knew they have to move to cloud, but they didn't know what could be the best way or what could be the better way of moving to the cloud. So we went produced our transformation program, and they really liked it. One of the cases where they feel comfortable was they knew that what is going to happen with each phase and what are the outcomes which they're going to get with each phase, which I'll help you to go through with regards to the way we pitched in and the way customer perceived the value. We'll talk about the first component. So let's say you are into Oracle eBusiness Suite 12.1.3. We start with as simple as a first process to do the quick assessment of your eBusiness Suite. And to do this assessment, we do not ask you questions first. We first see what has been currently there in system. For this, we have created an assessment tool which will go inside your Oracle Business Suite system and will get us information. To make this happen, in the background, what we have done is we have done the comparison with regards to the EBS features and the cloud feature. So you might be feeling that these are the features which I'm currently using, but is this available in cloud or not? So you get a ready reference of these assets, and this is really helping people to get confident whether the things they're expecting are available in cloud or not. Second, so we have compared around 642 features as we speak, and we more or less many of the things are available, I mean major of the things are available in cloud, not only like to like fitment, but there are additional features. You talk about, let's say, social collaboration, you talk about, let's say, OTBA feature where you get embedded analytics, which are over and above to the features which are not available currently in eBusiness Suite. This study has been done for the left side of modules, which you can see. It covers finance, procure to pay, project management, supply chain components, human resource, and as well as the EPM part, which is planning. Once we execute this assessment tool in the system, so we give you the assessment tool, you execute this assessment tool in your system. So we do not access your system at this point of time, and we don't intend to use it. Once you execute, you provide us back the information, the output which we get. We take that output, we do our analysis. On the left-hand side, you can see this is a structure of assessment report which we created, which talks about what is the current landscape. What is the percentage of cloud compatibility which we feel you are having. Key structure analysis, which talks about chart of accounts, talks about your HR organizations structure which has been set up. It also brings down the component of customizations which you currently have. Key master and transition data volume, so to understand that if also we want to go for a scope of work, how much amount do we need, what kind of data are we seeing currently. And in the end, we put forward our landscape with regards to the recommended approach. It would start with like-to-like fitment, which you can see over here on the left-hand side. So we give a fitment of what is there in eBusiness Suite and what could be there in cloud module. Plus, as per the requirement, because you always have a better way of doing the thing. So you want some new things from cloud also. Like this customer wanted advanced procurement, which they were not using. Warehouse management system, which they were planning to execute. So we suggested Logfire for it. And IoT to make that change happen from 5:1 ratio to 13:1. That is something which we suggested to go for it. These were the key takeaways from the assessment, and we felt that the combination of SaaS for the standard out-of-the-box solutions and Oracle PaaS for easy to build and integrate the solution would be a good combination for it. Now, when we embark this journey for you, let's say for an example, you connect to us and tell us that we would like to have this assessment for my organization and see whether I'm a cloud compatible or whether I should move to cloud or not. we do this exercise and we do the validation of our discovery, whatever the analysis which we have done, and then provide you back the report that this is what our proposition is. To make this journey comfortable for you, it is not only about the SaaS components which comes from the Oracle, but you would always have some specific requirements within your organization. So as an organization, we have 30 plus pre-built solutions, and we have more than 80 customers where we have done the past implementation, past development. And it also ranges from vertical to vertical. So we might have certain vertical solutions which you'd like to get from it, like EBS subcontracting solution. There could be a facility management company where they would like to have a property management solution, which is currently not available in SaaS. There could be a scenario where you would like to have a payroll of not suggested or not available SaaS payroll from Oracle. They would like to have it. So we have a developed SaaS solution for payroll. There could be a customer where you would like to have a multiple shift to be embedded within the system, and that shift solution is required. So that employee shift, if it is you're going for OTL, they might have certain limitation. But when you go for the EBS workforce scheduler, you might get extensive features over and above to what OTL provides. So this is how it is helping not to develop the solution from the scratch, but you can easily see our portfolio and try to see that this solution is something will be fitting in for the transformation journey. When I talk about the customization, I'm sure many of the people who are sitting over here would be mostly worried about this. And this is but obvious that when you have a lot of customizations, it could range from 10% to, let's say, 50% of the customization which you have seen in our past engagement. This is some of mapping which we have done, which will help you to just understand the terminology and what happens. So if you take a category of reporting, you might be having XML reports, the Oracle reports, or the Discover reports which you do. This is getting embedded within the BI publisher and OTBI, which is does not require additional licenses. You talk about custom application, so that could be a way where you have created a lot of OAF forms or Oracle forms within the, let's say, D2K technology. That could be moved or that could be redeveloped into platform as a service. So this is just to make you comfortable and make you understand that what happens on the Oracle Cloud about the customizations, what you have done. As the EBS, we do not suggest to move all the customizations which you have to the cloud. There are two aspects of it. One is about managing the customizations which you've created, and building that the same thing into Oracle Cloud might not be sustainable for that. There could be also a way where there is a better way of doing this. You might have done certain customization, let's say 5 years back. It is not necessary to go with the same way. There could be a better way of doing the thing. So we suggest that one. So we do the analysis and we suggest if there is a direct standard fitment from the Oracle SaaS solution, we suggest that. Second option could be as-is migration. So let's say a customer who is having a legal application built on OAF form, which is talking with the Oracle business suite at this point of time. Rather than redeveloping that thing, if the similar solution is quite good and they would like to retain that solution, we can do an as-is migration, and there are ways to do that. If it is not sufficing that one, then we go for the development part, and this is how we put forward an approach. When we talk about the customization, we also make sure that the customer team is collaborative with this. So the knowledge which your team is having with regards to development of reports, development of custom forms and other items will be enabled and will be used within the implementation. And we make sure that your people are confident enough to have business continuity during the implementation and post-implementation. So this is how we do the handshake and make sure your team is also compatible and help you to create center of excellence within your organization. This is something integration hub where we have developed certain solutions which could be utilized. And if you'd like to have integrations solution for it, we have in-house developed PaaS integration hub. Second component is about the insight. So many of the people say we are going for an implementation, but implementation is not necessary only about the technical part of it. So we believe in providing more, business value to the customer. So we put forward an approach which is, we call it as EBS Insights. We help you to create KPIs and create a business case which could be part of your transformation journey. So identification of KPIs, one thing. So let's say you would like to close your books faster than what you're doing. So let's say it is currently taking 12 days to close your books, and you would like to achieve 12 days to close the books, and you'd like to achieve this in, let's say, 6 days or 8 days of the time. Now, identification is one thing, and during the transformation journey, we configure the system and provide the trading accordingly. But what happens after the implementation? Because actual usage of the thing is going to happen post go live. So we have created value-based dashboard. So this dashboard will help you to understand whether you are really able to achieve that criteria which you have set up. So this is really working good, and customers are appreciating that EBS not only helps you to identify the KPI, but also helps you to do the monitoring of that dashboard and fine tune whatever the processes or the activities which are required to be there. These are the steps which are required for it. So we do the identification and then we baseline the KPIs. And during the implementation in step three, we align our transformation journey and the configuration of the items along with training in step three. And then we do the measurement at the period of 3 to 6 months. These are some of the customer case study which we have kept it. So it could start as simple as, let's say, improving the financial process. Now, to help you improve the financial process, this could be categorized into sub KPIs, which have been listed on the left-hand side. You would like to improve the payment process cycle, revenue recognition, another item, and close the books faster. What we have seen is most of the KPI, whenever we talk about multiple items with regards to getting faster, getting better, this could be categorized into 4 items. It could be about the process optimization, which you would like to do. It could be about the user enablement and the system adoption. A majority of the customers who are using e-business suite system might not be using more than 30% of the features which are currently available. We would like to change that equation when they move to the cloud. We would like them to use more features, more application of Oracle Cloud. And also in other side, we would empower the users who are going to use it, so they know why they are doing it. And it really helps them to do their task in a faster way rather than, let's say, additional admin activity. It could be as simple as like CFO and CA would like to see the information output. What is my spend analytics? How much am I able to save it, or how much where my growth could be there with regards to the business model which we have. It could be also for the audited compliance, where you like to check whether are there any system exception, are there any double payments which are happening to my supplier, am I paying right on time to my suppliers, or am I not able to utilize the credit time which I have been taking from my supplier. So these are the areas which you'll be able to get from these categories. And this is the model where we try to put it. So we identify the KPI and put the parameters against it. We do the baselining and benchmarking. So we take information from you, what is the current rate which you're doing, and then after make sure that what is the target which you would like to achieve. So this is the bookmark. The third column, which you can see, it is not a one-party job, as I said before. It is going to be a mutual ownership, where the green block can see that what are the items which customer has to take care of it, and the orange boxes which EBS will bring on the table. So we help you to provide the right value-based dashboards to measure it, but managing the SLA. So let's say the current SLA is not been provided to the user with regards to the activities which you want to do. Now, this could be redefined, or it could be, let's say, re-engineered, just to make sure that we are able to reach the strategic objective which you have noted. These are some of the sample of dashboard. You can see there are different dimensions which are available. It really helps customers to understand where they are moving towards to. This is more about the invoice receipt and the record cycle time. So you can know whether the problem is internal or whether the problem is external, whether the supplier himself is not sending invoices right on time. That's why it is taking longer than expected. There could be different. So we have more than 170 dashboards to help you get this across the business function. And you can monitor this in a better way and take the corrective measures. This is more about system adoption. So whenever we go live, we do the performance benchmark checking at this point of time and try to say that these are the areas where the users would be requiring more training on, or it could be the areas where people are not using that features, and provide you this information. To give you a summary of it, you can see all the modules and what are the transactions which have happened within the financial systems are being depicted. And then you can view this with the user summary, that who has done what, how much transactions have been done by which user, what are the features, or what are the features have been currently used within the, let's say, payment cycle of it, and are there any data exception? Like so many of the customer, what we have seen, they do not enter the invoice receipt date from the supplier. So if you're not entering that information within the system, it would be difficult to get the benchmarking report. So we also suggest best way of using the fields which are there in Oracle system, and just to make sure that you get the right reporting out of it. System adoption is something which we again are talking about, and you can see the summary. So this particular customer is not using spreadsheet invoices at all. Now either they don't know what is the use of spreadsheet invoice, or they do not need in the business. If it is the first case, then we help them to understand that part and make sure that they are able to utilize this kind of application. And similarly is for the recurring invoice. on the right hand side, you can see the user usage summary. 80% of the transactions are being done by the top 5 users, and remaining the transactions are by the remaining, let's say 80%. So this kind of slicing and dicing you can do, and you try to see that whether we are effectively using the system or not. This is more about identifying end baselining. So identification happens during the project, and the realization happens post project. Advisory is something which you have seen people going forward to, which is more about, let's say, what are the areas where it requires enhancement. It could be as simple as enhancing the chart of account which you currently have. It could be also about, let's say, multi-work restructuring, where you can have, let's say, multiple procurement units and a single payment unit, and vice versa. So that kind of mashup could be possible, which could have not been done in a business group. So that is something the people are appreciating and using it. Similarly, for other modules within the application. The important thing when you talk about the advisory part, it is not only about the application layer. It also talks about the cutting edge technology. So for this particular customer, we suggested to go for IoT, which is for the equipment service monitoring. So these are the tags which they connected their machines to. Now they will be fetching information about the current temperature of the system, different dimensions. Now this data will be connecting back with the dashboard within the Oracle into IoT dashboard, and you will be able to have a continuous monitoring of it. And whenever there is a spike or not required, let's say event, it will notify you that these are the actions which are required to be done. And it can be also connected with the person who is going to serve that particular unit. So it will help you to take the physical activity to system monitoring, and also do the assignment who should be the engineer which is closer to that particular equipment of region should go and serve that machine. And once it has been completed, the record within the mobile device of providing that this work is completed. So customer also gets the information, and the system also captures this information, which could be your part of SLA. This is how we see it is benefiting, and it will really help other customers also to have similar proposition whenever there is a physical to, let's say, system activities. AWS Cloud is our proprietary implementation methodology, and there are certain assets which I'll be talking about in this sideline. This is the timeline which has been there for the project. So let's say it's about kicked off in 2018, and there were certain releases with regards to the modules which they were having. On the left hand side, you can see the key phases which gets encountered during this implementation phase, and I'll be speaking about certain assets. So you talk about the project readiness. We have an our project management portal which is given access to the customer also. So both the parties are having the same view, what is currently happening, what are the repository of documents which we have, and if there are any areas of concern which are requiring action, it gets depicted within the same portal. Second is about CRP. So you all know that we have to configure the CRP and show you the system. So what we do is, as an organization, we have 1,000 plus Oracle Cloud customers, and we have certain instances where we have done the pre-configured vertical instance. So rather than developing or let's say configuring system for you, we start with that instance and showing you the application. This is what we do for this vertical. It really helps to accelerate the overall transformation journey which we have. And third thing, very important, is about the data migration. Many of you would be having a question, what happens to my data? Will I get all the historical data which I currently have in a business suite to Oracle Cloud? So we have a methodology and a proven concept for it. These are the strategy which goes over here. So it starts with the strategy, then you do the extraction of the data, transform that data, reconcile and load to the data. Against each phase, we have kept the accelerators which helps it. So strategy is something could be combined between us and you, where we see that these are the strategy which you'd like to do. These are the amount of data we would like to take from here to there. And the extraction of data, which is again, many of the customer are requesting that they would like to have an extraction as a service. So we have the scripts which are developed for Oracle eBusiness Suite, which could be utilized over here and tweaked as per the customer model, and then do the remaining item. Transformation of data. So we have created one tool, which is called as Glide Data Migrator, which will help you to do the transformation loading and the reconciliation from the tool. So it will help you to do the automation rather than doing that manual activity. Certain aspects which people are liking it. So it helps you to do the automation. It helps you to do the time saving whenever you go for the data migration. And it also optimizes your viewpoint with regards to the verification and quality check, which you'd like to have. Training assets. So we do not believe in providing the training at the, let's say, before the go live. We believe in providing training throughout the project which we have. It could be as simple as, let's say, the quick learning attribute with regards to what is the Oracle product and how does it look, what is the navigation it goes in. It could be as simple as, let's say, providing your IT team at least a starting line item that this is how the Oracle Cloud works, this is how you can manage and you can maintain this. And during the CRP, we always try to provide more, showing more system to you so that you get more accustomed. And if you're seeing more of that during the implementation, the chances of using that system in a better way are higher once the go live is being done. So this is how we try to provide more training to you. Not only this, I was talking about certain assets which talks about what is gold in eBusiness Suite and what is that gold in Oracle Cloud. So that is functionality mapping, which helps people to understand the type document or something which was in eBusiness Suite. Now in Oracle Cloud, that is called a self-service procurement. It could start as simple as into the module fitment, and then it can be drilled down with the features which are available in it, whether let's say the features which are there in iProcurement is available in Oracle Cloud or not. If it is available, what is that called as? So that kind of thing is really helping people to leverage and make sure the adoption rate is higher. We have created custom reports and localization library. So there could be certain reports which are required by the localization or by your region are available over here. So you can pick and choose that reports. And if it is not sufficing your need, we do the custom development for it. So this is something which we have a custom reports library. This is more about the implementation. Once the implementation is done, we have a proper way of doing the support part of it. And there are many activities which goes into the support. Not only keeping the lights on and providing the long-term support, but also to provide you value-based dashboard, which will help you to at least get intrinsic value with regards to the value what you're getting from the business perspective. It helps you to move from reactive to the proactive mode. It is not only about the guesswork which you might be doing, but to move to the fact work out of it. And this have been categorized into four sections. These are a couple of case studies which are done within your region. So Algiers is something we have done in Saudi group. They were having a business challenge where they wanted to unify the ERP systems and do the transition state from SS to B. So this is something which they would like to have. The solution deployed is arranging, I mean, all the major components of ERP suite has been covered in, and it took around 60 weeks for us to complete this. The benefits which they're getting is the program which we have put forward, adopt approach, is something which really worked for this customer, and they realize the benefit. 2B state, what would be happening into 2B state, that is something been effectively appreciated by the customer, and the hypercare support where the knowledge transfer is there. One of the important item is about the pre-built solution, which I would like to highlight over here is, we have an EBS bank facility management solution, which has been embedded with the vertical experience which we have done. So this got suited for the customer, and they really were able to get this timeline as well as solution from a pre-built past developed solution from EBS site. Our second customer, which is about to go live, so this is work in progress currently. It's a Gulf Drilling International. They wanted to have a historical data migration, data cleansing part. They wanted to have, let's say, inbound materials. So these were the challenges which they had. From the solution side, it is again similar to that multi-pillar or multi-modules which have been implemented, ranging from financials, human capital management, supply chain, along with warehouse management. Benefit, again, they were smooth and efficient EBS to cloud transformation program. That is something which they were happy with. And then 2B business blueprint, which has again been associated with this customer along with the past platform which we have. This is something which I wanted to take you with regards to the journey and what are the ways you can move to the cloud. As a next action, what we feel is you can connect with us for the subsequent activities and any items which you'd like to have one-to-one engagement. We can help you with the option appraisal, that what could be a better way for you, whether it could be staying into the current version, whether it could be upgrading to Oracle Business Suite 12.2, whether it could be moving to the infrastructure as a service of, let's say, OCI or cloud solution, or it could be moving to the cloud roadmap, how good we can go and whether it is really good for me or not. And then we can go back with the blueprint stating that this is what we feel is good for you. You can write us back with the email of business@evosys.global, and we can also connect you with the right people with the sales and the pre-sales knowledge who can support you this engagement. Now we'll check the question and answer and try to respond certain questions during the timeline. And if any of the questions are unanswered, we'll try to revert back with the emails of whomsoever has been responded that question, just to make sure that you get the better value out of this webcast. Okay.
Thank you, Vikas. That was really an insightful session. So we are open to questions now, and we have one of our attendee, and the question is, how do we migrate our must-have customizations to cloud?
So one of the section, I'll just go to that slide for the ease of people to make sure that they understand this part. Let me just quickly go through that. So this is our customization object handling methodology. What we do is we do the technolysis and the bifurcation of the objects which are there currently in system, and you tell us that this is what is really required to go on the cloud because there is no solution available. This is must have for us. We do the business discussion for that particular item, do certain analysis of it, and then if it is standard fitment, because you might be having that it is not there in that Oracle cloud, but that would be a possible way of getting that into Oracle cloud, either standard fitment or the workaround. If we feel that this is something which is great for you and works for you, we go with the standard fitment. If it doesn't, and if the component are such in a case where it has been developed in OAF or let's say ADF technology, then we have an option of moving that particular solution into infrastructure or let's say platform as a service, and then connect the interfaces which are currently connected with the business suite and change it to Oracle Cloud. Or it could be a redevelopment of the activities of whatever the way which you want, either as a form altogether or the custom application which you would like to have. This is how we do, and this is how customers are getting value out of it. Hope this answers.
Yeah, hope that answered your question, Onkar. And Onkar has again asked one more question. EBS Glide is tied up with only EBS or with PeopleSoft, SAP and MS Dynamics.
So at this point of time, when we speak, there are four products which are coverage of EBS Glide. One is Oracle eBusiness Suite for sure. For this webinar is there. We also have the similar proposition for PeopleSoft, where there are also a change of, let's say, on-premises to Oracle Cloud, which is happening, and unlimited, let's say, support that's been tied up with certain deadlines. So we have the PeopleSoft coverage from the Oracle landscape or Oracle install base. Another product which we have from the non-Oracle landscape is SAP. So we are supporting SAP Enterprise Central component, which is also similar to the case where it is going end of support in 2025 or 2027 with the latest release. So we have this program for SAP ECC. And the fourth component is Unit 4. So Unit 4 is something which has been widely used in UK and other region where we have developed a similar program to bring Unit 4 customers to Oracle Cloud. So these are the four components which are currently linked with the client approach.
Thank you, Vikas. So we had similar question from Abu Bashar. Hope that is answered as well. And Raid, we would share the presentation with all our attendees. We would share the gist of it. So you will have a view. So we are open for question for a few more minutes. Yeah. So if you have anything.
Yeah. You can send across in Q&A. And if you'd like to unmute yourself, just give us provide a hands up. We are more than happy to do that. I can see Abu Bashar raising your hand. Abu Bashar, would you like to speak or typing in question? I will unmute you. Yeah, I've unmuted you in case if you'd like to put forward your question. Okay, I guess the questions was there in Q&A, so right. Probably that was a previous hands up. Do we have any other people who would like to understand more about it? Omkar, I guess it makes sense and you get a right value from this webcast. If there is any other questions, just let us know or provide your hands so that we can unmute you.
There's Sam Joseph who would want to unmute.
Okay. Yes, yeah.
Question basically is, what is the impact percentage of past customization while Fusion auto upgrade? Yeah, that's his first question.
Yeah, absolutely. So there is a bit impact, but it does not have a big impact like what you have in eBusiness Suite. What we normally do as an organization is, if you're going with the long-term support with EBS, we do a sanity testing. Now, sanity testing will include the new feature addition which are coming up into the new, let's say, release of Oracle. So we provide a training session and tell them that these are the new features, and we feel these features are applicable for your organization. So that is from the SaaS perspective. What happens in the past perspective is, are there any major changes which are going to happen in SaaS where the past component is going to be redesigned or redeveloped or anything? So we do a complete cycle testing for it. And if there are any changes which are going to happen, we put forward this message clearly to the customer. But that is very hardly, let's say, very few percentage when you talk about less than 10% of the changes are required during the upgrade.
until unless it is not a very major release upgrade, which happened in, let's say, HCM in last year, which was a major release upgrade. So Senate testing was a big item for that. But otherwise, it's less than 10% of a change.
Yeah, Sam has another question. Is it necessary to test past custom solutions before upgrade? What is EBS's recommendation?
Yes. So it is not about, let's say, end-to-end. I mean, it is more about sanity testing. So we try to see the major pieces are working and interacting with SaaS and PaaS, but otherwise within the PaaS company, it does not require a lot of efforts to do it. And this could be part and parcel of the service package if you would like to opt for it. Or we enable and train you during the implementation that these are the steps you should take care of it when you do the upgrade, if you intend to do the business continuity process within your organization rather than relying for the support with a third-party company.
Yeah, those were the questions.
Any other questions, anyone? We can pick a couple of questions before ending this.
Okay, Christopher Jyoti, he has a question. How about validations using custom
ELL and user hooks? So we have a couple of cases where user hooks, which is very much appreciated in the business suits, are required to be there. So there is a way to create similar hooks in Oracle Cloud also. So we try to understand that part first from the customizations which have been built upon. And we provide you that this could be a possible way, like we are showing you the mapping of the things which could happen in Oracle Cloud. And during the implementation, we make sure that at least whatever the key components are required to be there, it gets into the Oracle Cloud. So this is how we try to merge this gap. 60 week of implementation is not long yet. So again, what I'm saying over here, or what I'm going to try to put up a picture over here, we have a cases like, say, KU Children's in Australia, where we had complete implementation from Oracle or complete transformation from Oracle eBusiness to Oracle Cloud in as low as 12 weeks. So that is a record-breaking transformation program which you have done for that customer. And we also have a cases where the implementation had gone for, let's say, more than a year, considering the complexity, change management aspect, what they have, and the line of business, what they have currently using for the cloud system. So these are the way we feel there is a difference of, let's say, ranging of transformation duration taken for it and the impact which it causes. And we are more than happy to suggest what could be a right time for you, considering your landscape and you're considering your environment about the change you're looking for transformation. Okay, pretty much okay. Just a last note from my side, any of the questions which you have and if you'd like to have more interaction or understanding on this, we are more than happy to have one-on-one workshop for you. And just to make sure that you are quite comfortable about the action item which you'd like to take from your current e-business suite to either staying back with the e-business suite or going to an option appraisal for Oracle Cloud. All of these services are available with EBS, and we are happy to provide you the best way you should have it considering your current situation. Thank you.
Thank you.